Hello from Kazan. It's 4 days to go for the Socceroos' date with destiny against France in their opening match of the 2018 World Cup. Seb Hassett's with me. Seb, behind us, all 23 in the squad are accounted for after the four were rested yesterday. And the three goalkeepers are getting a thorough workout, as we can see. That's a positive sign, isn't it, that Juric and Co, Rogic and Naboot and Sainsbury are on the pitch?
Yeah, there was a little bit of concern about them yesterday when they didn't train. I think that not seeing them out there, of course, everyone's on sort of high alert. But we were told by the staff, don't worry, they'll be out there tomorrow. They were good to their word. They're out there today. I've just been watching a few of them go through their paces now, and they all look like they've got a clean bill of health.
OK, how about that story on the World Game website about Didier Deschamps' comments saying that under Bert van Marwijk, Australia are a lot more adept at getting results at this World Cup, a lot more balanced in a defensive sense. How did you take those comments?
Mind games, pure and simple. I think those comments will be very well received by the Australian camp. It'll probably make some of them feel like they're on the right path. But I think that's just probably him trying to sort of butter up Australia and really take away any sort of edge that might come in that sense. I think it's just pure and simple mind games. I wouldn't be reading too much into it. We'll see what happens on the day, but that's my take on it from here.
Okay, three players spoke today, Mathew Leckie, Josh Risdon and Aziz Bayich. Josh Risdon cut short his honeymoon to be at the World Cup, said that except for his honeymoon, this is probably the most important part of his life. Interesting, he's saying he's got to curb his totally offensive instincts against France in the first match.
Well, we know what kind of player he is. Even though he is a right back, he loves to get forward. We see it every week in the A-League. That's his natural instinct. That's probably his best asset too, I think, as well. That's probably what got him noticed to be here. But when you consider the opposition that he's going to be coming up, particularly in the first game against France, I think he has no choice. He must come back. And of course, there will be a time during the game when he probably has to bomb on a bit, but more than anything else, his defensive duties have to be front and centre, and I think he recognised that.
Well, if he plays, and we know Aziz Bayich is most likely to play, the fullback's role for Australia will be ever so crucial given the wide threats that France pose. But I'll get on to Aziz Bayich. He said he was in career best form with his club Bursaspor in Turkey. We know he's stepped up to the mark after being a fringe Socceroo a couple of years back. He's one of those guys that can make a real difference.
Yeah, he is a player who can make a difference, and I think he's shown more and more confidence every time he's played. He's really spending a bit more time on the ball. He is driving forward. So a little bit similar to Risdon in that regard. He also made the point that he has to be aware of his defensive duties as well. But I think they'll look for plenty of drive coming out of him. I think he's a player that's improved dramatically. And he's seen off some considerable opposition at left back as well. Mm. So I think he's a very important member of the squad.
Mathew Leckie's had a great season with Hertha Berlin, coming off a double against the Czech Republic. He's one of those players that can really turn a match. We saw that against Chile in the World Cup 4 years ago. But what about him? Uncomfortable times as a wing back under Ange Postecoglou. He looks a lot more free and adept at his natural qualities as a winger.
Yeah, he was having to do a mountain of work, wasn't he? And I think that was probably something that might have stilted some of his sort of naturally offensive part of his game. He's a player that can run it. The opposition, he can cause problems with his pace, his stamina and work rate. I think we'll see him really flourish under this new system, under Bert van Marwijk. I think that the change to the back four enables him to be able to sort of just focus on that side of his game. And just for the amount of work that he can do, I think he's going to be very important, particularly in covering the ground. And that is something that all the Australian players, not just him, by the way, will need to do, particularly against France. And we saw it in the game against USA that France played, that the numbers that they're able to get back, even the attacking players, and how many problems that caused France. And I think Australia will have noted that, particularly that front third.
Absolutely. We'll have more on the France likely team 11 tomorrow. And it's been great chatting with you, Seb. Stay in touch with all that's happening in the World Cup on the World Game website, #SBSFootball. Until next time from Kazan, we'll see you soon.